Alright. Spawning in the left side of the map, playing as Odin. It's Joe. I'm shocked to see him picking Odin. He's an Egyptian main. But he wants to go for the counter pick to kill Ulysses Uranus, as we all know that Odin counters Uranus in most of the maps. And Joe is really lucky with the map spawn. I'm gonna admit, Joe is extremely lucky with the map spawn. Two gold mines, probably almost maximum amount of hand to be spawned. And he also got maximum value out of the great hand, so this is amazing. This is amazing for Joe. It's on him to throw this game and lose it. Rusty the Relic, Hatter's Folly. Kinda useful for the Ravens, maybe not as useful for the Uranus player. Since it also works on the Ravens, and on the right side of the map, playing Uranus, it's Ulysses. His main god. He started with Uranus, he mained Uranus for many years, he copied Aya's playstyle and he improved it. And he evolved to be one of the best Uranus players currently playing. As what I really like about Ulysses is how he's spending his resources and how he's macroing his units. I would say this is Ulysses' strongest part. Being always on zero resources, on food, wood and gold. Because he's spending them on upgrades and on the army at the same time. And on top of that, he's also macroing his units with an amazing APM there, so... Yeah, and about Joe. Joe's strong part is probably also his APM. But... with his decision making, I would say what Joe is better against Ulysses is at the decision making. That's his strong part. He knows when to pick a town center. He knows where are his power spikes, and he has an amazing good micro over there. Usually, a good Odin main would go for double Ulsharks on this map, get all of the goats, and get an easily access to the mythic age, getting the food all the way there. But Joe is not really an experienced Odin player, but he is extremely strong as a player in general. He will try his best. He will try his best to win with a counter pick over there, which can happen. An economy upgrade so far, just handed dogs, pretty standard, same for Joe I'm assuming. There are a few old school side builds that you would go for a super early hand axe and pickaxe, but this kind of builds would only work on no patch maps. Joe having his temple up, kinda exposed, but he will be more than fine if he upgrades his towers. Isn't Yuli main Uranus? Yep, I said that. Ulysses is an Uranus main. So this is a 430 from Ulysses, and it's a... what is it? And a 430 from Joe too. Seven villagers on hand, excuse me, 4 on wood, and 4 dwarves on gold. Maybe he had some idle town center there. I think he did have some idle town center. But that's fine. You're Odin. You have a strong economy. How's he getting thrown? Prey on the way. Ulysses is already upgrading his pickaxe. I wonder if he's gonna go for hand axe too. Yep, he goes pickaxe hand axe. To try to be able to reach the Odin economy. Even though I feel like Odin and Uranus have the same economy. Correct me if I'm wrong, but... I would say they have an equally strong economy. With the difference that Odin will lose if the game goes to farm transitioning. That's why most of the times you wanna go for a fast Ragnarok. Not only because Uranus and Atlanteans in general have some bad anti-infantry units. Like the Kyroballista and Fanatics are pretty bad to counter infantry. Because the Kyroballista dies so quick. And Fanatics can only be trained at the Mythic Age and only through palaces. But you also wanna go for the fast Ragnarok because you don't wanna play a game where you're forced to make farms against Atlanteans. This is usually what you're gonna do with the Greeks with a second early town center. But you're playing Norse. You cannot go 99%, you cannot go for a second town center against Uranus. Jotrang του χαράς Ulysses. Ulysses with a second Promethean over there. And this is another thing that Ulysses does quite well. Spamming units, spamming army. Spamming, I mean, economy upgrades. And also spamming myth units at the same time. He's really playing Age of Mythology over there. He's making everything. Ulysses doesn't forget about anything. He will make all type of units that are needed. Prometheans, Marmillos, Turmas, there he goes, going for it. See a few Wolf Sharks. It's kinda risky to send those Wolf Sharks without Lone Wanderer to raid. Enjoy's housed. Alright, he finally got his house up. And I'm gonna agree with that. Not many goats for Joe over there. He might play for the map control. And these Warduses are pretty close to his main base, so he could always try to hunt them with a max population army and with forest fire. Let's see if Joe will be able to force a defensive shockwave. Most of the times when you play against Uranus, you wanna force a defensive shockwave so you don't lose the big battle later on. 5 Hersies, I think that's an overcommitment. If Ulysses scouts that and stops making Prometheans, he's gonna be able to win the main fight, in my opinion, especially with Shockwave. Lone Wanderer, finally on the way. Joy's housed once again. It seemed like he was going for a fast heroic because of the amount of resources he had, but no, he was actually housed. Yuli, trying to get some aggression done. Joe's not spending his resources at best. Ulysses is just floating army over there. This is where probably Joe should stop making units, get towers, get armory, and go for a quick frost. You have enough gold in your base, you have enough goats to get to the heroic age. Go for it, kill the army with a frost, jump Ragnarok, and you're good to go. You don't have to classical fight here. You don't have to. And on top of that, you might even lose if you go for the classical fight. As these buildings are pretty exposed, Yuri will take advantage of it and attack them. Joe also trying his best to raid, but his raids are not doing anything for now. And Ulysses is still making Turmas, which makes me think, what will happen if Joe manages to get to a full population there? He will just win the fight against Uranus. This is where you win against Uranus if you won a classical fight. In a full population fight, where Uranus doesn't have Shockwave or have already used it. Or when Uranus has many Turmas in the battlefield, because these Turmas just do like 4.4 damage, which is quite weak. And Joe lost already 4 of his Hersies. There we see the Shockwave. Would he be able to snipe a citizen? No! Ah, at 4 hit points. But the Forest Fire being used will be more than able to kill the citizen. Joe is also losing villages here and there. Ulysses is getting closer to the full population. Trying to raid once again. Cutting the reinforcements. Nice job. Snapping units, more throwing axemen. There are no Hersies anymore. These Prometheans will do a ton of damage. Ulysses is getting a second town center. This is why he's low on score. Joe would really regret it, will really regret it when he notices that he has no goats anymore to sustain his army production. He would be like, why I didn't go for second Ulfsark at the start? Why I didn't do that opening? Anyway. Joe missed this. Joe ran around here and he missed this citizen there. He could have killed it easily. Nakiro Ballistas are mixed in the fight. Second town center is up. There we see some units getting sniped. And I really wanna see how Joe is planning to get back into this game. As he's extremely behind, not spending his resources well. and not thinking clearly, not thinking clearly, you cannot just stop your army production and not upgrade your towers. You cannot do that. You gotta throw the wall chips, upgrade your towers, and then stop the army production. I feel like Ulysses will be ahead even if he loses his entire army over here. This is how I feel like it is. More citizens getting harassed, but the Kyroballistas are there to defend. Kyroballista going down, nice micro from Joe. Time to retreat, nice hit and run play. Was that a relic? I assume it was. Second Valkyrie was trained, but I think Yuli has enough heroes to defend, as we see. Look at how quickly the Valkyrie died there to the hero Turmas and the hero Marmillos. This is a bad fight for Yuli, but once he gets to full population with the town centers, he will just win every fight. Let's see the micro. Joe will be stuck in the heroic age because he's making muscle sharks with Valkyries. He's not gonna have any food or gold to advance. He's going pretty all in over there. As he's not going to give up yet. There are no heresies in the battlefield to kill the Prometheans. And the heroes are there to kill the Valkyries. And what will Joe do at this point? Will be funny if Ulysses manages to catch up Joe on the villager count. Because he's playing Atlanteans. You probably guys know what I mean. Okay, Gorduses being hunted. Ulysses will advance to the heroic age faster than Joe, even out of the two town centers. And the farms have started getting dropped. So Joe has a timer here. If Joe also goes for the farms, the game is completely over. But if he manages to get to Ragnarok and Frost before he makes any farms, then he's good to go. Let's see the raid there. Manor will die. Hyperion is also on the way there. When you see Hyperion and you play any sieve, that's not only for Odin, but when you play any sieve and you see Hyperion, remember guys to send your myth units to raid. This is really important against Hyperion. Because if you have your myth units in your main army, then the Valkyrie will fight against your units once Chaos is used. So take your myth unit, send it to raid, and then your opponent will not be able to use the chaos because it will basically do nothing. The Valkyrie will still attack the villagers, even when it's chaosed. Joe took some nice trades over there and he's getting close to reach Ulysses at the score since he's spamming with units and he gets favor from that. Scud on the way. Heavy Marmillos there for Ulysses, plus with copper weapons. Yep, copper weapons. He's gonna demolish those Ulysses arcs pretty easily. Joe trying to distract until he gets to Frost. But Ulysses is close to get to the Mythic Age here. Will do a ton of damage using the Tartarian Gate and kill villagers with it, and the Ragnarok will be way weaker. If Joe manages to get to the Ragnarok, let's be honest. Frost Giant on the defense. A nice good deal with the two Prometheans. But no, Joe is not paying attention over there. Joe still trying to raid and force mistakes. Yeah, guys in the chat, you don't have to be so emotional. Nobody was roasting anybody. And it's kinda rude to me saying to anybody that, oh look, that player is better than you. That's kinda rude, I would say, so... Yeah, show some respect to each other, at least in my chat when I'm streaming. Thank you very much, guys. Alright. That Valkyrie is almost dead, can use the rest of them to take down the Kiro Ballistas, especially with the... I wanna pronounce that correctly. Aura Borealis? I think that's how it's called. I don't trust Boyd when it comes to unit names and what else, and to upgrades, because Boyd calls... Ah, never mind, Joe calls it, GG. Yeah, I was saying that... That a mistake that boy does is calling Helepolis Heliopolis. I will say that another 10 times probably. It's Helepolis, guys. It's Helepolis. I'm a Greek. I'm a real Greek. Alright. I really wanted Joe to win at least this game so we could see a third game. But he calls it.